We're here in the Bayou City, Houston, Texas. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Cougars having a wide receiver like this, I think sometimes it even helps a young quarterback because this kid goes out there, he works hard in practice every day, and I think he really lifts the whole offense.
I think he does. I think he's almost like having an extension from the coaching staff into the locker room with the players. He's a guy that makes big plays, but I think he takes it upon himself to be able to help out with some of the other receivers, make sure that they're all on the same page, understand the route adjustments, understand everything that goes on with being a wide receiver and the importance of blocking. So all the little things that seem to add up and make big plays, I think this guy totally understands his responsibility being a go-to player.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48. Zips it to the tight end. He's taken down around the 43-yard line.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
He makes his way to about the 32.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 32. He's at the 20. Fires it out. He's tackled at the 13-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 13. Scrambling. And they get the sack.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
From the 13-yard line, it's second down. And he's tackled around the 3-yard line. That's good for the 10 yards. Third down.
Watch number 12. Watch number 12. There we go. Here we go. Set it. Blue 19.
The ball is loose, and they fall on the loose ball.
A lot of guys in the defensive backfield are ball hawks, and the safety showed it there by pouncing on the football.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Tackle around the 25-yard line. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
First and 10, ball on the 25. He can run. He's at midfield. Inside the 30. To the 10. Touchdown, Texas. And he converts the extra point. A quick two-play, 95-yard drive.
And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
And the big plays that they have running the football were the keys to that drive.
Texas gets set to kick this one away. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Longhorns are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
So the offense comes out after their last drive, had the ball end up in the defense's hands by way of a fumble.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Feeds it to the back. He makes his way to about the 42.
He gets another set of downs, and more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff. Coach is going to have to be happy with that one. The defender was in the right position to make the play.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. He's on the run. Tries to get around the corner. He might have a chance. Knocked out of bounds. Around the 37-yard line. Steps out at the 36-yard line.
It could be that the offensive coordinator is trying to lure the secondary in to play more press coverage. And then they'll try to take advantage by going deep. Those safeties better be ready.
It's second and 8. Ball on the 36. Quick throw. And down he goes at the 23-yard line. Going to try and scramble. There he goes. Slides down. And this is the 8th play of the drive. Defense has had 2 stops already down here. Pressured and brought down.
Loss of 6 yards on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Third and 8. Ball on the 21. Zips it to the back. They'll bring him down at the 20-yard line. Henry picks up about a yard with that completion.
That'll make it 4th and 6.
He gets it up, and it's through the uprights. Houston is lining up to kick this one off. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
Brought down right around the 42-yard line.
First down.
From their own 42-yard line, first down. Texas is up by 4. At the 30. Tackle made at the 25-yard line. So we've got a first down after a great running play. They'll spread the field with five wide. Throws this one out to the right. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
That's good for a gain of 23 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Touchdown, Longhorns. And that's his second touchdown of the day.
Boy, Brad, this guy's having a huge first half. Already two rushing touchdowns. And we know he can throw the football. I love to see his willingness to be able to run with the football, and it puts so much pressure on a defense.
And he hits the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 27. The Longhorns are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you've talked to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down like this.
Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things change in a big way before halftime. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And they make the stop, the 48-yard line.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play-action pass.
Tries to buy some time. Looking for the corner. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 34. And he has a huge gain.
Yeah, I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks. He sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him, and he takes off. Ends up with a great run. Keep 15.
First and 10. Ball on the 34.
Hey, blue 14. Yeah.
Back's got it on the quick throw. And he's taken down around the 6-yard line. Here they go. First and goal, down by a couple of possessions. He's scrambling, keeps it, and he's got a touchdown.
Things can get pretty fierce in this territory, but they look totally in control there.
He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Texas holds a 4-point lead. And he tackles him hard at the 39.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. Got an opening. He's at midfield. Gains his way to the 49-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want to run out of this.
First down.
He tackles him for a loss.
The option is all about timing. And on that play, the timing was just off. That's going to happen sometimes.
From midfield, second down. And he throws it away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
He goes downtown. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. Now it's first and goal with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass.
Mike three.
And he's tackled right away.
Number three on the tackle at the 2-yard line. That brings him second and goal.
Come on, baby. Let's see what you got.
Texas is up four. Quick throw, tight end, touchdown. The tight end does a nice job coming down with that touchdown catch.
He certainly did, Brad. This guy's a big-time threat inside the 10-yard line because of his size. He can out-muscle defensive backs for the ball.
And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Cougars struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game, and sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how it can do. They got to get the ball in his hand somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play, one touch could get this guy going because he has that kind of ability. And up to this point, they've not been able to find a way to get him the ball. Give credit, a lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands their go-to guy.
Campbell on the handoff. He's taken down right around the 28-yard line.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That makes it third and seven.
It's third down and 7 yards to go. Ball on the 28. He scrambles. He's tackled right around the 44-yard line. Push him out at midfield. Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 50-yard line. Now he's scrambling. And he's tackled at the 46-yard line. quick throw. They'll knock him down for a loss. And they back up 3 yards on that play.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
Throws it in a hurry. And he is drilled at the 41-yard line.
Number 11 makes the tackle at the 41-yard line.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Pulls in the pass and steps out.
Well, on third down, we expected them to go to the air, and they did just that, picking up the first down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. Tackle at the 37. There's a strike complete. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Loss of about 2.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
Scrambling around. They bring him down.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
He's looking for 6, and he's got it for the touchdown.
This guy just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
The coverage just couldn't keep up with him there. And he converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Texas is up by 4. And he's hit immediately. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Throws complete, and he's hit hard behind the line. A 1-yard loss.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
First down pass to his tailback. And down he goes at the 41. 98 Weasel! 98 Weasel! He's on the run. He's at midfield. Dives for extra yardage.
It's always a snap decision when you decide to tuck it and run. On that play, it was definitely the right move as he got the first down after a nice game.
So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. He wants it all, going long. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. We've seen quite a bit of offense here as we reach halftime. Our score is 21-17, Longhorns.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
I completely understand an offensive coordinator's philosophy. If a play works, just keep going back to it over and over and over again. But I don't know, something seemed a little unusual about the play calling in the first half here.
I know what you're saying. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Yeah.
But if it's money, then put it in the bank and continue to do it over and over. He kept dialing up the money plays, man. I don't need to run anything else. If my money plays are going to work consistently, until you stop it, you better get used to seeing green and cha-ching, 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 because it's money in the bank.
Are you trying to say behold the power of cheese? Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 26. This offense has really seemingly been unstoppable. Should be interesting to see now if the defenses change things up as they try to stop these guys. He's going to try and scramble. He keeps it. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 49. From their own 49-yard line, first down. Texas holds a four-point lead. He's hit and taken down.
That'll make it second and inches.
So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Here's an opening. They'll bring him down at the 15-yard line.
That's good for the 26 yards. First down.
From the 15-yard line, first down. Pitch out, got the corner. He's on the run. Touchdown, Texas. And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They come out in an empty backfield. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 24.
Mike 41.
And now he's got room to run. There's a fumble. They fall on it. Brought down at the 34. So the question here is whether or not his knee hit the ground before the ball came out. So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after some discussion, the call on the field is reversed. Out of bounds at the 35.
Gain of 3 on the play. That makes it second and 8.
From their own 35-yard line, second down. And that one's incomplete. Flushed and they got it. Worthy, back to return it. Booming kick. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. Gets him open field. He makes his way to about the 28.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Almost intercepted. They make the stop at about the 33-yard line. From their own 33-yard line, it's first down. It's caught, first down, and he's out of bounds. That one's more than good enough for the first down.
Well, Brad, that is a great play by the quarterback to find his target past the marker to keep this drive moving.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45. Tackle made around the 49-yard line.
Gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it
second and four. Tie right, Mike three.
And he hits him hard at the 28. From the 28-yard line, first down.
Mike three.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That makes it second and six.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. And he's taken down right around the 16-yard line.
Call it a gain of 8 yards.
First and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line.
Mike three.
The 10. Touchdown, Longhorns.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Texas to kick this one off. Golden from the one. And he just got drilled. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
Quick throw out to the receiver. He's taken down around the 41-yard line. From their own 41-yard line. First down. Now he tries to buy some time. He's at midfield. He's tackled right around the 46-yard line. the 22-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 22. He's scrambling. Dives, and he's down. We head to the fourth. The Longhorns with an 18-point cushion. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Sets them up with a first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. The short yardage defense here. Touchdown, Houston! Took it in for the score.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
So the offense is going to go for two. And he's in for two. So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was inbounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
Houston is lining up to kick this one off. He's taken down at the 22. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He sails it long. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Tackle at about the 17-yard line.
That's a gain of 61 on the play. First down.
Now it's first and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Gets out to around the 9.
Gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
Mike 3.
Tackled after decent pickup.
Call it a gain of 6 yards.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Down.
push him out at the 2-yard line. This should be an easy field goal.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Kicks away, and they tack on 3 points. Texas ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 24-yard line. And for Coley, what a night it's been.
Well, what's great about this offense is having a quarterback that can hurt you both running and throwing, and we've seen that today.
Well, his team is trailing, so he's going to have to keep up the high level of play. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold?
Mike 41, Mike 41.
There, do not do it.
He scrambled. Fumble. Defense has it. It's one of the corners. And down he goes at the 40. And that one's recovered by the cornerback.
Funny, because you usually don't see corners down there picking up loose balls. They're more worried about interceptions.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Just over 2 minutes in the game. Up the middle for a nice game. Baxter gained 7 yards on that play. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. And off to the left. Nice run to the outside.
Well, that's a great job by this offense. The defense knew that the run was coming, and they still could not slow them down. Pick up a first down and allows them to continue to work this clock.
Houston's called their final timeout. 3-yard gain by the halfback on the counterplay. Second down and 7. Ball on the 26-yard line. Nice run there. Baxter gains about 4 yards on the play. Third down. Knocked out of bounds at the 11-yard line.
Very intelligent play call. Dialing up the option on third down, and it worked like a charm.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 11-yard line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Bring him down at the 13-yard line.
That brings us 3rd and 12.